Sydney Independent MP Zali Steggall has admitted a mistake was made following revelations her 2019 campaign had received a $100,000 donation from a coal magnate. The Liberals didn't skip a beat in calling out the MP for failing the pub test today. All the while, a Federal Integrity Commission is officially off the cards.
The climate has changed for Zali Steggall.
Are you interested in my answer or you want to tell me what you think?
After it emerged, she received a $100,000 cheque as a donation from the family trust of a coal investor for her 2019 campaign against Tony Abbott. The cheque was then split into 8 separate donations, all falling below the threshold that requires public disclosure.
Look, it's very suspicious. Particularly from those that talk so much about transparency.
Ms Steggall won over the people of Warringah with her strong stance on climate change and integrity.
We need to restore faith, integrity and respect in our political process.
Today she's feeling the heat for those donations.
I was trying to unseat the former Prime Minister who's been there for 25 years with a $2.5 million war cheque.
Putting it down to...
So, you know, rookie error, absolutely did it.
Apologising this morning...
We corrected it as soon as we could.
It hasn't appeased the Prime Minister...
There are a lot of people who are happy to throw stones, but they're offered in glass houses.
Or his Liberal colleagues.
When you look at how this was done, it was designed very carefully to achieve the outcome of not disclosing the donation.
And now to cover up the cover-up, and that's what's happening.
It's the latest incident which brings into question the rules around political donations.
Everyone's got to play by the same rules, and when you get a big donation, it goes up on the website in real time, then you wouldn't have any of these problems in the future.
A Federal Integrity Commission was another one of Scott Morrison's 2019 election promises. Today in Senate estimates, the Attorney-General confirmed it's dead in the water.
Well, the government's not progressing with it at this stage.
Stella Todorovic for 10 News First.